Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you some Python code using which you can actually create a answering machine. You can ask any natural language question, just like you can see a few questions on the screen, and your Python code is going to give you an answer from a paragraph that you are going to supply to it. And the good thing is you don't have to train this, and number of lines are less than 10, I can say. Creating this bot, you can use it as a bot, you can use it behind Slack. Okay, so let us start it. First, I'm using Colab. You can run it on your own laptop. Okay, if you do not know how to use Colab, I'll suggest you to see my another video, which is a very small video how you can use Colab, where you can use GPU and TPUs, though we do not use a GPU here, but I'm going to use Colab. That's all. So what you have to do is you have to go to Colab, go to the first link of Google and create a new Python 3 runbook. You have to use Q&A demo. Okay, this is the bot name. Now you have to use pip install AllenNLP and shift enter. I am going to do. So it is going to install AllenNLP libraries. AllenNLP contains a lot of demos and open source codes for machine comprehension, for text similarity. What I'm going to use is machine comprehension one. Okay. Allen Institute has also released the model that I'm going to use. It is on their public internet. I'm just going to use the code that I've already written and tested. I will use a predictor. Let me copy it and paste it here. The installation is over. Yep, you can just see it. What are the logs? I'm not interested, so I'm just removing it and going to use another blank cell. Here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create initialize a predictor, and this is the path of their release model. Right now, it is 44 MB approx, and this is based on BiDAF, Bidirectional Attention for Machine Comprehension. Okay, let me create it. For as it is a first run, it is going to download this model and cache it. It is going to download it. Okay, you can ignore this warning. Let me create one another cell. Here what you have to do is you have to create a passage, any string where you are going to write the text from which you are going to ask your questions. I have copied this content from Wikipedia. This is you can open anything. I prefer India because it is my country, so I prefer asking question from the content that are posted on internet Wikipedia. You can see this is a big text. Okay, let me execute it, and then this is the last piece. I will simply start asking the question from this model. Okay, so predictor that we have already created here, predictor dot from path. Okay, that dot predict, I'm going to supply the passage that I've written here, and the question that I'm going to ask. Whatever the result is there, variable is there, I'm going to print the best pen string and to the console. To save the time for this video, I have already tested some of the questions. Okay, let me ask this question one by one. Let me ask, what is the GDP growth rate of India? So it says 5.8%. Let me, you can verify it from here. 5.8%. Let me search here. With an average annual GDP growth rate of 5.8%. Wonderful. The other question is also a simple question where you are going to get the simple answers. How many political parties are there in India? 7. It is also there, political parties. It has 7 recognized national parties, right? So if you ask this question, it will be very difficult, and this question will of course be interesting to you. How are union territories managed? This is not a single word answer. The remaining five union territories are directly ruled by center through appointed administrator. This is a wonderful answer found by this bot, where it is pointing exact the start point and end point from this paragraph. You can use your own paragraph and find the questions. The remaining seven are directly, see these, I can ask how many states are there, it is going to tell me 29 states, and how union territories are managed, it has given the answer. Okay, now this is the bot. What you can do is you can put it into a loop where you are waiting for some question from Slack or any other UI channel. If and when some user asks a question, you can simply execute this and return the answer. If you know how to create a Slack interface for this bot or any other bot, there is another video you can see there, where you can see in how 5 or 10 minutes you can create a Slack bot. So if you combine these two videos, you actually can create a bot in just half an hour, where you have a UI interface of Slack, where you have a backend natural language, state of the art, I must say, this is one of the state of the art NLP engine which is answering your question without any training. I hope you might have liked it. Thanks for watching.